Hello everyone, my name is Imani and welcome back to Silver Creek Falls Chapter 2. I believe this is probably going to be the last episode because we're on day 3 and there was only 3 days on the last one. I feel like this chapter is coming to the close. Last episode we just met with our new partner's New Jersey contact who happened to be part of the Mafia, and then apparently this entire hotel is also owned by a Mafia. And weird stuff always happens in room 801 because there's a weird conversation about a clown there. And now we're off to new things. So let's do that. There's gonna be another cat thing. I'm gonna be pissed. Okay, there's no cat. I'll have to give you hotel key. Oh. Ah, here we go. That was way easier than the cat thing. What did we do that last time? Seems the trail on Connor Friedman has gone cold. Any ideas? I could ask around my Mafia contacts more, but that's really wasted favors. Besides, I have another lead. Cool. What do you have? Do you remember that poor deputy that was killed in Silver Creek Falls? Mike. Oh yeah, Deputy Hill. Poor kid. He was so young. His landlady found a note for him in her mail. I think this might open things up a bit. It's been a week since Deputy Hill was killed. Why did this not come up sooner? When she first got the note, she didn't realize it was for him. It was only later when she looked at it again did she work it out. I had her fax it to me. Check it out. The cipher that unlocks the message is on my carpet. L. Davis. Oh, he must have sent this right before he, like, disappeared or something. Ah, crap. Lee Davis must have left this for him to find so he could decipher those crazy notes. Guessing your FBI crew grabbed them from the police station? The originals were stolen when Special Agent West was murdered, but I do have photocopies. If you had photocopies this entire time! Why haven't we been looking at them? So back to Silver Creek Falls? Yep. Alright, here we go. Sorry, Sarah, I think I have to get this. Go for it! Hey boss, what's up? What? Uh-oh. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, it's actually on our way. No problem. What's up? That was my unit chief. Apparently there was another incident. Oh, no. It's over Creek Falls? Not quite, about 30 miles away, in a small fishing town called Walleye Head. You said it was on our way? We need to take a small detour to get there, so chances are we won't have time to see anything in Silver Creek Falls today. Fair enough. Shall we get going? Uh-oh. Here we are, the holes in the blood. Hi, Sheriff Majors? That's me. I'm guessing you're the FBI agent that sent to take a look at this? That's right. My name is Special Agent Valdez, and this is Detective Sarah Fitzgerald. Sheriff. So what's going on here? Mighty strange case up here. Mighty strange indeed. I reckon you folks best take a look for yourselves. Can you please give us some background on what's going on? Certainly, ma'am. Last night, a lady named Maddie Colwell called saying her husband and brother-in-law hadn't come home the previous night. Two brothers named Chester and Eddie both worked at this warehouse you see here. What was this warehouse for? I reckon best we mosey on in and I can explain things better. Y'all have pocket handkerchiefs on you? I'll tell you, it smells like dead varmint in there. Lead the way. Holy crap! That's a ton of blood! That's way more than should be possible by two people. Look at all that blood everywhere. This might be even worse than the sorority house of Creek Falls. Now y'all need to understand that they gut and clean fish here, so perhaps some of that blood could be fish blood. Fish don't really produce that much blood. Not that much. I don't think humans produce that much blood either. Thanks. Shall we get to work? Survey and analyze the scene. Collect any necessary evidence. Jeez, this place really stinks. When I got the call from Mrs. Colwell, I'd reckon the first place I'd find Chester and Eddie would be the warehouse, since this is where they work. Ah, it smells really bad. To answer your early questions, warehouse where they pack frozen fish for the Schwartz Fishing Corporation. That explains the smell. Schwartz was a name that was brought up earlier for something. Land? Like they had bought some land from the Cherokees or something? Just to show what you know about fishing, boy. Fresh fish doesn't smell, nor does frozen fish. Yeah, see, that's the weird thing. When I got here, not only did I find boxes of fish outside the freezer room, but this darn mess of blood and guts everywhere, too. Any bodies? Negative, just blood everywhere and this darn mess of fish left outside. What did you do next? Now, I heard something mighty similar, so I went down to Silver Creek Falls, so I sent my... report to the chief of police in Charlotte. In turn, he passed it on to the commissioner, asking, I know you FBI are involved. If you have any more questions, I'll be here. So you're closing the case here? Keeping a sharp eye out, but there's little else I can really do. There are no bodies, so I do have reason to believe the Cole brothers could still be alive. On the other hand, there's a lot of blood here. Blood sample added to inventory. That's a white perch. Fish added to inventory. More blood sample. More blood sample. Power needed to activate freezer door. Blood sample. Blood sample. Fish! This one is an American shad. It looks exactly the same as the last one. Blood sample. White perch. Roanoke bass. Bullhead catfish. Blood sample. Frozen walleye. Finest fish in the Atlantic. In the Atlantic. If you ask me. If you ask me, no punctuation, the founders of this town liked it so much they named the whole darn town after it. Blood sample. A discarded fish. Man, it sucks that so much of this went to waste. Yep, after we file the paperwork, we're gonna have to throw this all away. Guessing the frozen fish too? Affirmative, there's some bad juju on that fish. Schwartz Fisheries has been pressuring me to let their cleaners in already, but I want to keep it the way it was for you to see what I saw. Schwartz Fisheries, that rings a bell. See? I was right. Subsidiary of Schwartz Banking Corporation. Its members descended from the Jebediah Schwartz, the founder of Silver Creek Falls. That is interesting. For a long time, they're the most influential family in these parts. They still have a lot of power, though. It's a bass. Roanoke bass. Why is there a mattress here? There's another man who worked here. We knew him as Old Clyde. He slept here at night, too. He was homeless. Was he also reported missing? Old Clyde ain't got no family. The only people who really knew him were Chester and Eddie. Heck, I don't even know if Clyde is his real name. Seemed to know a few things about him. Were you the sheriff of a town of 600 people? Then there really is no one you don't know anything about. Looks like they were having a few beers at work. Blood sample added to inventory. Blood. More blood. More blood. Oh, imagine that! More blood! Man, there is a ton of freaking blood around here. This one is out of place. Looks like an Arctic char. You seem to know your fish, Sheriff. Everyone around here knows their fish. It's a fishing town! This Arctic char really doesn't belong here. Are you sure it's an Arctic char? My brother lives in Newfoundland and I go up north to go fishing with him when I get the chance. That there is an Arctic char. Now whatever the hell's doing down here is a mystery to me. That really is interesting. And of course, this is a walleye. That should bring the power back on. Extinguisher. The right one for a warehouse like this? Nope, the fire extinguisher is not up to code. Looks like I'll have to fine Schwartz Fisheries for the violation. So they need the industrial size one, right? Yep, they have a big generator at the back to power all them freezers. They need an extra large industrial fire extinguisher since they own one of those. Generator? You mean they are connected to the grid? Nope, we're miles away from walleye head itself. Is that the freezer to the left? Ooh, why is this packing out so far away from the town? Fishermen drop off their catch here before heading back to port. Saves on transportation fees since this warehouse sits by the river. So no chance of any witnesses for whatever happened here last night? No, ma'am. Police must wash hands before resuming work. Valdez, check this out. Oh my gosh, that's a go-head, isn't it? It really reeks, but it's been there for a while. It's so gross, it still has the hair and horns on it. Any sign of the rest of the goat? Wait, there's legitimately a goat. I don't see it in there. Nope, just the head. That's really weird. Nobody raises goats around here. I wonder where they got it from. There's more. A bottle of blood and some candles. There'll be the devil to pay. Something unholy happened here. There are always rumors that the Cole brothers weren't all right in the head, but this... Let's not speculate anything yet. Sheriff, please add all this pile of evidence. Yuck. This gray water has been sitting here for days. Our local catfish. I can hear the generator starting up. Looks like the door is still jammed. Yep, still jammed. Why do you need to stop? Holy crap! Fuck! Oh man, that surprised me! I saw something in the corner of my eye. Door shut too. Must have been from the stored air pressure in the freezer room. Still doesn't explain the thing I saw. Yeah, what's with all this weird static junk ass? Now it won't open. Let me try. Nope. We can walk there through the fence outside. Something's not right here. Blood. Blood! And frozen perch. Blood! Wait, is that? No, it can't be. It is. Dang nabbit, it's a foot. Here, I have a plastic bag. A foot? Like a human foot? Frozen catfish. No. We gotta go back. I ain't done. Nothing about this vent? Frozen runic bass. Frozen walleye. Alright, time to go outside, I guess. We should probably take a look around, round out back quickly. It was probably just the wind from the generators. I know what I saw, I think. Actually, now that I remember, old Clyde did have one other friend. Really? Who? A Native American man named Eric Johnson. You see, when old Clyde appeared here in Walleye Head, most of the townsfolk were none too pleased and didn't receive him very well. Eric, knowing a thing or two about being disenfranchised, was very kind to Clyde. He gave Clyde a job at his convenience store and even let him stay at his house. So, what happened? When the tornado hit 2 years ago, poor Eric lost his convenience store and house. Seeing it as a sign, he gave old Clyde half of his savings and left Walleye Head. What a generous man. If you believe in karma, you'll like this story. He moved to Oklahoma and ended up making it big there. That's awesome. What business? I understand this may sound like cliche, but he owns a casino there. Of course. You could try to track him down, ask some questions, but I don't think the two of them were in touch. If you're trying to look for him, you won't find him by looking for Eric Johnson. He now goes by Golden Hawk. It's also the name of his casino. Thanks for all your help, Sheriff. My pleasure, son. Wait, are you considering going to Oklahoma to follow this lead? Seems like a bit of a weak lead, so probably not. So I really should get back to the case in Silver Creek Falls. Think this case is related? Most likely. So we done here? That'll be all, Sheriff. You have all the evidence and samples? Sarah hands the sheriff all the blood samples and evidence. Yep. And you continue on to Silver Creek Falls, but I'll type up a report. Maybe someone from DC might come down and take a look later. Alright, let's go around back. Animal hair again. We're not gonna pick it up. Someone cut through the fence. Or did this did a really messy job of it. Like, I guess nothing here. Yeah, now there is nothing here. I don't trust that. I guess it's time to go. Why are we not picking this up? Anything else? No? Alright, let's go. Beaumont Rock Mountain, Nash County, North Carolina. Oh no, not again. They even have one here. Welcome to the Beaumont Rocky Mount. Well, this is pushing it. We're not even in Hawthorne County. We're like 2 hours away from Silver Creek Falls. They have their own hotel there, you know. You know, I want to spend as little time as possible in Silver Creek Falls. Oh, yes, Special Agent West. I'm so sorry, I forgot. Besides, I've accumulated enough points to give myself the deluxe room tonight. Seriously, how did you become an FBI agent? Did you collect 10 chocolate wrappers and win a job there or something? Nah, man, that's ridiculous. I only had to collect 5. I like this guy. Let's check in. What's on this TV? Barbecue channel? Interesting. We take our barbecue very seriously down here in the South. What an awesome channel! I'm gonna try to add this to my cable package at home. Interesting. Mr. Valdez, always a pleasure to see you. Likewise. Giacomo, to room 69, please. Right away, Mr. Valdez. Oh, you have enough points to upgrade one room for the night? Would you like to? Absolutely! Please. There we go. Ricardo called earlier to tell me that you were coming, Miss Fitzgerald. You have room 803 again. As for you, Mr. Valdez, you have the penthouse. Sweet. I'm so sorry, Giacomo, but I need to ask our Stefano and Ricardo, your brothers. Why, yes. How did you know? Well, I'd guess when you've been a cop as long as I have, you get wicked good at observing things like this. You mean besides the fact that they look like exactly the same? So pretty early. You want to go through some of these case files together? Oh, tonight's the last episode of Mr. Chef. I kind of really wanted to watch it. Oh, it's only 6 o'clock. Doesn't it start at like 7:30? Just gonna go buy some popcorn and a pastrami sandwich. I also want to get my hands on some Lexington-style barbecue. And if we look up a lead this evening, we might end up chasing it and end up in some crazy part of the state by nighttime. Besides, aren't the Red Sox playing tonight? Oh yeah, how could I have forgotten? Deal, let's take the night off. How did you know I like the Sox? Please, your Boston accent is so thick, I thought I had Mulk Wahlberg in the car with me. Boston born and bred, baby. So, does that mean I can go up to the penthouse and see he's there? Maybe? Man, should I go to the smokehouse to pick my own cut of meat, or should I have it sent here? Do I have time to go grab some pastrami and popcorn? Decisions! What a problem to have. Ah, this is so frustrating. Can I have a look at your room? Go for it. Let the jealousy begin. Maybe Mr. Popular will be a gentleman and swap rooms? Nah, I can imagine him whining about how they're his fancy FBI points. Pass. Should I go up? Cooking shows really aren't my thing, and also, I don't think he wants to share all that food he bought. I'm gonna go jump in a bed in my room and watch the game. Why? What if I want to go look at it? Oh, screw you. Gosh dang. What's in room 801? Let's just go straight over. Yep, here it is again. Letter in the drawer. We have to read this one, right? Dear Mr. Ortega, it's done. After hours and hours of work, I think our chefs did it. Once we released the sweet and sour chicken burrito and the pork chipotle spring roll, people think twice before messing with Ortega's Taqueria and Mr. Lou's Dumpling House. These fine products will finally dominate the El Dorado Shopping Center food court once and for all. No longer will we bow down to the power of the clown. I can now see the envy seething out of the eyes of the employees of Kimchi Express and Pizzeria Luca as we steal all the customers. Kind regards, Lu Xiaowen. Is it to pick up your gift from Moscow? I must say that Idaho is a really beautiful state, and I really enjoyed my time in Moscow, Idaho. And I can't believe I thought this was something criminal. Lame! Anything in 802? Never. Alright, let's look at the TV. Sweet Caroline, that. Whatever. Alright. Bedtime. Sleep for today. Oh, it's day 4! It looks like we're gonna have another episode! Alright, so we'll go ahead and end this here, and then we'll start on day 4 next time. This is longer than I anticipated it would be. I'm excited, because I thought it was gonna end today, and I was worried. Alright, I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.